in your Twitter bio, one of the ways you describe yourself is as a science storyteller. And you certainly mm-hmm. have done that in your TED Talks. And you do a great job of weaving the science with the story and then incorporating it together to present an actionable message. And so I wanted to ask you, what makes storytelling such a powerful tool for you and for science in general? And how have you leveraged that skill as a science communicator to bring attention to more issues that the general public should be aware of?
I think story is one of the most powerful and important tools that any of us have for connection. I think we're moved by story. I think we learn through story. I think we connect via story. I grew up in a house of readers. I love reading. I grew up in a house of storytellers. We'd stay up late at night, making up stories with each other and uncles and cousins, sitting around a campfire, that kind of thing. And it's just how I understand the world, and I think it's how a lot of people understand the world. And when it comes to science storytelling, what I think is so important is that so many people find science to be unapproachable, or, a lot of people have this, I think it's changed a lot in the last 2 years with COVID. But in some ways, COVID has sort of underscored a lot of this, which is there's so much complexity in science, and it can be very difficult to make that approachable for people that aren't trained in science or like think in just a different way. And, we're all wired a bit differently. My brain really does not connect well with like chemistry or physics. It's a very specific type of science that I relate to and feels tangible to me. And I think that what's powerful about story is it makes things tangible that our minds might not otherwise connect to or relate to or understand if we're just learning it in an academic setting or even in the news, and I'm sure all of us have read those articles or books or whatever that are super dry and you're just like kind of falling asleep, but you really want to know the thing, but it's just like very jargony and technical and boring and horrible and dry. We've definitely all been there, and I hate that just as much as the next person. And I've been lucky in my time to have a number of teachers and mentors who could bring things to life in a way that was more compelling. And that's what I see in the power of story, is it creates an emotional anchor in some ways that brings things to life. And also, in some ways, I think especially in this last year and a half or so, it can engender trust. Like we need to be able to trust where we're getting information from. And ultimately, there's a lot of disagreement and confusion because people aren't sure where to place trust, or they're placing it in places that aren't, acting in good faith necessarily. I think about this a lot when I think about the anti-vax movement, and which is also using the word natural as a weapon, basically, to prevent people from getting vaccines. And it's just such a shame because vaccination is one of the greatest technologies that was ever invented and saved so many millions of lives. It's unbelievable, and the sort of agenda against that is killing people. And I think that story is a really powerful way to connect, and people are using it in all kinds of ways to deliver information. And I think that it's a really powerful way to allow science to be embodied, basically, and to allow people to connect with that science and learn something that otherwise can be really complex and feel really difficult to understand. And I don't think it's a question of like dumbing things down. I think it's a question of we all can learn. We just need to use a language that's common. And story, to me, is a tool to allow for a common language for learning.
Yeah, story is such a powerful tool, and something that I try to use as a podcaster, whether it's in the actual podcast or through creating content and clips and writing my own thoughts down, even if I'm not sharing them, to create a story arch. And the way I've experienced science communication from my point of view as someone who went through most of life not caring about science education, just doing what I had to do to get through it. Like a lot of people in school where, maybe it's not part of your major. I was a business major, I did accounting. And so it was kind of like my prerequisite and get it through, didn't really care, was going through the dry things. And the last 2 years, I would say, my science content consumption has spiked, and it's not because I don't think it's because I just have an internal drive that was that's being elevated to explore science. I think there's some things that are happening internally, but I also think it's people like yourself, and I brought up Andrew Huberman before, who recognize that there's science and then there's also making people give a shit about the science, and those are two entirely mm-hmm. different things. And the way you present that information with storytelling makes me care. It makes me want to listen to mm-hmm. a podcast for 2 hours about hearing or sleep. It makes me want to listen to two TED Talks. It makes me want to be curious about science and develop that curiosity. And I really do appreciate people like yourself who are scientists, and also I don't want to speak for your process, but as someone who's observing your content, it seems like you definitely put in the effort to make people care. It's not just like, this is science, so you should care. It's like, how am I going to translate this into an exciting mm-hmm. and fascinating manner?
Yeah, absolutely. And I appreciate that. It does take a lot of effort and thought. And I think that's why so often people have, negative experiences with their science learning, is because it's not a common skill among scientists, I don't think. And I've definitely advocated in my own community, in the science community, for greater public engagement and greater effort to learn how to do that. And, you know, I was really lucky. I got a lot of training in that at UCLA with my mentor there, teaching with him for years. And then at Harvard, I actually took some workshops with a theater director of the American Repertory Theater, who did workshops on story and movement and how to connect with an audience. And, you know, I put in a lot of time into that because I really deeply care about it. And I think it's really fun, and I think it makes a difference. And I think ultimately, you know, there's a lot of ways to make an impact. And there's a lot of people who just, they're so good in the lab. They're so good at the bench. Mm-hmm. They're so good with their focus. And for me, I see a lot of my gift and a lot of what I want to do in the world and for the world is being able to translate and being able to storytell and being able to create impact that way through education and awareness and advocacy. And it's a different skill set, and you know, we, not everyone needs to have it, but I think we need to recognize how important that is and elevate that as something that is important training for scientists and for anyone who cares to make an impact in the world.
Hey guys, thank you so much for watching. As a reminder, you can become a premium subscriber today. Watch the full uncut 2+ hour episodes of the Auxoral podcast, plus gain access to 2 bonus episodes every month at auxoro.supercast.tech. Link is also in the description. Thank you so much for supporting quality content from independent creators like myself. Cheers.